opposition also 17 minutes. So I was beginning to wonder where the clarifications, and sometimes clarifications also became justifications, but we will leave it at that. I will take a absolutely non-partisan view on this. Firstly, I think the original sinner was the GATT agreement of 1994. So the GATT agreement of 1994, where it was clearly stated that we have to cap the procurement should not exceed 10% of the value of production. The problem which has happened, and it's remained till 1994, Minister, is that this recalculation hasn't happened, and the prices which are being calculated on are 1986 and 1988 prices. So the question here is, since you've come back, if we do the calculation based on the new prices, which are 6-7 times higher, where does that take us? That takes us way beyond the 10% cap. So, the first one, that was an inherited flaw. Please tell us what is the current flaw, where the developed countries have still been kept out of disclosing their subsidies. The developed countries, that's $400 billion, if you take EU and North America together, they are still not disclosing those subsidies. This is our understanding is, and clarify, please, our understanding is that we made three offers. The first is to mark it up to current prices. The second, they made an offer to link it to CPI, rejected. And the third, and this is crucial, to allow us the break of allow us the opportunity to breach the 10%. There is not a clarity on that. Please give us a clarity on that, because eventually the understanding is, and I think the government needn't feel shy of this, you had an opportunity to be part of a $1 trillion economy, or you had an opportunity to come up with a statement like yesterday, which makes 1 billion people in India. So it's a tactical decision. Now, the government is very keen on pushing some so-called reform forward in the name of FDI, and you people are in a big hurry. You want it done in a particular date. It has to be brought up in this session. It has to be passed in 3 days. The same point here is, I'm not making politics, but the same point here is that, fair enough, if that agreement which you thought you'd sign before the 31st of July 2014, we are on the same page as you. You do not need to rush into signing that agreement. Try and sign it in December, try and sign it in February, but the cutoff, as you know, is August 2015. And the last point, sir, you know, in the kind of communication strategy you've used with the Prime Minister and for his election campaign, we compliment you. It was a very good communication strategy, because communication strategies need to work, and you got the numbers, so there's no question. But the minister is here. Actually, that's former minister. I'm sorry. Maybe we'll get
him. No, please.
No, he's got mixed up between former and farmer. Anyway, so on a serious note, with such a great communication skills at your beck and call, why are you not putting those communication skills to use? And I agree with Anand Sharma ji on this one. Take us into confidence. Talk to us. Whether it's a big international issue, or even if it's something which is a bill, if you put those communication strategies to use, I think you'll find all the solutions. But overall, we've always believed that the food security bill, for all the rara we make about it, is impractical at times, and it's also unwise. So we are with you on this, but please, next time, get everybody on board. If you haven't found a solution in July, not a problem. Look for one before March. Okay. Thank you.